Welcome back, amigos. We're on our way to Universal's Sapphire Falls Resort, which, did you know, is home to the largest pool on Universal property.
The pool itself does have an infinity entrance. I'll show you, amigos, here. Ooh, it's a bit chilly. And we have two sides. We have the left side, which houses the slide. And then there's the right side, which is the much bigger lagoon side. Sapphire Falls does offer in-seat service, meaning a server, just like this team member right there, can bring your drinks, your food. If you don't want to order through a server, there is an option for you to walk up to the quick service. They have like hummus and pita, pizza, chicken tenders, wraps. Temperature-wise, it is a bit cooler. The thermometer says 78 degrees, but if you're visiting from up north or even out west, you really can't complain that it's 78 degrees in Florida. I only point this out because when you get out of the water and the wind is blowing, it might be a bit of a shock. Even though the Sapphire Falls slide is down for refurbishment, here's a peek of what's to come. I guess you enter right there. But, amigos, I found something that might interest you if you're visiting during the winter time. So, adjacent to the pool is actually the Sapphire Falls Jacuzzi. So, there you have it. If you're feeling adventurous and it's a chilly evening, just jump in the jacuzzi right after, and it'll warm you right up. If you are looking to partake in some libations, there's the Drum Club. It's nicely sheltered. You have your beers on draft. Your frozen drinks. The pool bar is open till 10 p.m. However, you can only get food till 9 p.m. If the pool does close early due to the weather, the pool bar also closes early. So just plan ahead, amigos. There's a real nice seating area right next to the pool bar. You guys can see it's got the nice seats with the backs. It has the umbrellas and... here's a special treat. During the evenings, if you're looking to unwind after a long day at the theme park, this is the place to be. Wrap yourself in a towel, get yourself a libation, and just chill out. So Sapphire Falls is a moderate resort, meaning it does have some nice touches of like luxury. The pool area is heavily landscaped. You can see the big giant windows that lead you from the rooms to the lobby. It really gives you a sense that you are in the Caribbean, which fits in well with the theme of this once thriving sugar mill plantation. The fitness center on site is called Kalina Health, and it houses traditional workout equipment, treadmills, bicycles, elliptical. There are some freestanding weights as well. I'm not sure how many people exercise while they're on vacation, but if you do, that's awesome. You'll definitely feel well equipped here. What stood out to me was the locker room, which you don't have to work out to use. You can just use it to change in and out of the pool. There's a traditional locker system here. Basically, you put your stuff in, put in your code, return later, no key needed. There are four showers for private use within the men's locker room. Not sure how many in the ladies. And all these showers have your soap, your conditioner, and your shampoo. There's a four-story stone turret in the lobby. And the reclaimed wood really gives the appearance of an island mansion, beautifully restored. As you kind of meander through the lush oasis, you notice the cascading waterfalls. But this like wine cellar really stands out to me. It's sandy stone, crisp, clean walls. This oversized plantation shutter feel, I just can't speak enough about. The resort is also home to four restaurants, two sit downs, and two quick services. This first restaurant is called Amistad, which is Spanish for friendship. And if you've seen this channel before, you know I'm all about seating. So these type of chairs tell me
welcome. We want you to stay. We want you to enjoy your meal. The restaurant is very open. You can see the large communal tables. The reason there are so many communal tables is because this resort is also a convention center. So you can see that large party over there. I wonder if they're with this convention. But the seating, again, no matter where you are in the restaurant, well padded, very warm. I feel like I can take my time when I eat, which is really important to me. It does have an open kitchen concept, so you can see the chefs preparing the food as it's happening. I really like when Universal focuses on that. It really creates this kind of warm, welcoming, we want you to be here feeling. I feel like it's very transparent. I don't know, I'm always a sucker for these open kitchen concepts. It is pretty warm right now, so if you are coming in January, you can sit outside. You can see the sugar mill. It's a breathtaking view. However, the seating is, well, I'll let you decide for yourself. Wooden chairs, no padding. There are heaters. We did have a couple cold days in December, but I wouldn't sit outside. Here is that open kitchen concept again. You can see the chefs plating the food, probably for that convention center. So the servers kind of just walk up and wait. So you can see as the food is being ran. Really neat if you ask me. Amistad is open for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. My favorite thing here, I really like the rotisserie chicken. But I know that the queso fundido, I feel like that's been heavily reviewed on TripAdvisor. Everyone's like, stick with that. As we go back upstairs, if you're a parent looking to go to the parks at night, this resort does offer a kids night out camp. Basically, you pay $15 to have the kids supervised by a trained professional, and then you can add a $15 package if you want the child to eat. Strong Water and Tavern is only open for dinner. It's 4 p.m. There's a tapas-inspired menu. So our favorites are the Mexican seafood tostada, or the Jamaican jerk curry goat. There's the U.S. Virgin Island Black Angus sliders. Basically, you get three tapas for about $30. So we're gonna head over to the Hard Rock Cafe for lunch. But just an update, amigos, you don't get free express pass when you stay here. You do get early admission into Volcano Bay and into the Wizarding World of Harry Potter up to 1 hour prior to the park opening. So I took the ferry back to City Walk to the Hard Rock Cafe, and there's nobody here. I think everyone's inside the theme park right now. It's about 1:30. But I like it here. It's a fun restaurant. The menu's not gonna blow you out of the water. It's like traditional American fare, but it's like good portions. It's fun. The music is really loud. You guys can see up there Elvis, one of the rock and roll god. I think that's like, I don't know who the other two are. Maybe Jimi Hendrix. There's a revolving pink Cadillac that goes around the bar. It's really good for pictures, like for Instagram. I think it's supposed to be like Elvis's caddy. I did have to use the restroom. Interesting enough, you have to go downstairs because there's only one bathroom. So these are the stairs I took to go back to my seat. When you go back up, you go through the photo op. Disclaimer, amigos, whenever you eat here, they're going to stop you and be like, take a photo. And then they come to your table and they're like, would you like to purchase the photo? They didn't ask me because I was by myself, so I was like, I'm good. Well, let me show you my lunch. It was cold ramen salmon salad. I know, odd name, right? But it was $21. It was delicious. There's a teriyaki glaze on top. I almost couldn't finish it. That's how large it was. I probably could have split this with Justine. And I just got a water. Nothing special. I did get to use my annual pass, so I got 50% discount. Amigos, that's our day at Sapphire Falls. Hopefully you enjoyed the resort as much as we did. And that's what's great about staying on property. You can eat, you can sleep, and then you can walk to the theme parks.